Have you seen Ted Lasso? It's about an American football coach who knows nothing about soccer, hired to coach a sad sack British team for reasons unbeknownst to him in the hopes that his ignorance will cause the team to lose further and fail. But Ted Lasso is the kind of person who can't help but to inspire. He brings out the best in people, as athletes, as executives, and especially as humans. And that's the audacity of the show, that a good, upright, upbeat, positive, optimistic soul and indomitable spirit can be the centerpiece of a really funny comedy. That's radical when you think about it. And it's not that there isn't darkness to it. Everyone Ted encounters is on the edge, including himself. But he never gives up in his quest to make everything and everybody better. So it got me to thinking, could that work in real life? Could there be a Lasso effect where people make the choice to be good and fair and help each other just because if you want the world to be a better place, it's the right thing to do? And I could already hear many saying, yeah, well, maybe that could work on a small context like one-to-one. But to me, for the Lasso effect to work, to make the concept provable, it has to reach further than that. There's no reason that the Lasso effect couldn't act and be effective on a global scale. Follow me here. Imagine a world where instead of greed, people were generous. Instead of cruelty, there was kindness. Instead of selfishness, there was selflessness. You might say that's crazy, but isn't it crazy that we think of those things as crazy? Aren't they the sanest things you could imagine? You might say, well, that is a reality, but isn't the fact that it's not reality the weird part? Shouldn't it be reality? Why isn't it reality? That's the question. Would anyone really complain if it was the reality? Why isn't life like that? It might seem like a naive question because we've been brainwashed and conditioned and propagandized to be cynical and skeptical about goodness and fairness and justice. We think there's an angle. It's a scam or a lie that we can't change. That's what they want you to believe, that goodness and fairness is for suckers. Goodness and fairness are bullshit. But what if it wasn't? They, and there are many theys, want your mindset to be, look out for number one and fuck everybody else, because the power structure benefits by separating us and making us craven and greedy and covetous and acquisitive instead of inquisitive. The power structure perpetuates itself by making sure you don't give a fuck about anybody else, by making you afraid. Afraid of the very things that makes us humanity. They've instilled that fear in you that you might lose everything if you're foolish enough to care. So in theory, when you employ the Lasso effect, yes, you are being kinder and in turn making everyone around you kinder, but you're also striking a blow against the evil empire because they are counting on our unspeakable personal horrors and the exploitation of our fears to justify their large-scale corporate horrors. And if they can appeal to your fears, then they've made you a slave without you even knowing it. But if we're good, where does that leave them? If we're all really good to one another, we wouldn't even need them, would we? I don't know. I mean, sure, Ted Lasso is also made by a company owned by another company, and somewhere down the line, a multinational corporation is involved. So would they really sow the seeds of their own destruction? Surprisingly, maybe. After all, what's a company? It's not like the sun or the sky. Companies and corporations have always been here, and companies like individuals, groups, territories, species are sometimes counterintuitive. Sometimes they sow the seeds of their own destruction without realizing it, and soon they're gone. So would a company put out a show that might be the catalyst to bring down the entire system? It's so inconceivable that they probably laughed off the whole proposition, like those scientists in science fiction movies who scoff at whatever disaster they're being warned about, and then the tsunami or earthquake or the large asteroid strikes, and the laughter turns to screams when they are unprepared. So imagine the power unleashed by the Lasso effect. Is kindness the deadliest of weapons? Is being good the ultimate radical revolutionary act? Can you be too good? Is there a point where people freak out at the incomprehensibility of your goodness? When is good bad? When is good a negative? I mean, we've seen bad. We've seen bad on a mass scale. We've seen genocides and holocausts and wars and random day-to-day extreme violence. We've seen mass bad afoot. But we haven't seen good on that scale. Maybe ever. Mass good. Think about that. So that's what I was thinking. Could we ever be as good as Ted Lasso? Could we impact one person's life, one person's pain dramatically by helping them find a way to be better? And in turn, them offering the same help to another. Can we do that on a mass scale? Can we be so good that we blow somebody else's mind? Or we blow an entire population's mind? Until regardless of governments or ideologies, people transcend those arbitrary boundaries and connect to really be there for each other, to help each other. So until Jesus returns, we might want to follow the path of Ted Lasso. He'll never give up on you. He'll always be there for you. He gives hope. He only wants to help. He wants nothing in return except maybe you being nicer to someone else. Imagine if we evolved that way. That's the Lasso effect.